Hey y'all, what's up? So we have another story for you guys, another true crime story, another true crime show review. Yes. And this story is from the show Web of Lies. And on Web of Lies, basically, it is a show based on tragedies and murders and twisted events and things, all based on web events, like from the internet. So
right,
you know how the internet streets are. Wow. So you know this story about to be wild.
Right. So most of the show is about people who meet each other online. Yeah. It could be, you know, exchange of social media, things that happen on Facebook. It could be all types of things. So that's Web of Lies. So if you want to check it out, Web of Lies, I believe is on the ID channel. It might be on Oxygen. You find out.
Yeah. So this episode, they up to like about season six or something. This is about season six. Yeah, they have a lot of stories. But this story is called Murder Goes Live.
Murder on Facebook.
No, Murder Goes Live.
Murder Goes Live.
Anyway, from the title, you already can kind of guess where we're heading with this. I know you heard about this story in 2017.
But 2018.
2018. But this is when the guy actually kills his girl.
Let's get into this. The show starts off with a woman named Anita Williams. And she sits down and she's already in tears.
Report police. What's your emergency?
Can you send the police to 1301 Madness? Because he's shooting.
Okay, is he shooting now?
Yeah, he's shooting now, ma'am.
Okay, is everybody safe inside of the residence?
No, ma'am.
Okay,
what's my daughter in there with my son.
Like, before we even hear anything, she sit down, she's in tears, they introduce her as Renita Williams' mom. So then, after Anita makes a 911 call, I'm sorry, they play the audio of her making a 911 call. She talks about how Renita Williams was very beautiful. She talks about how she was a social butterfly, and this day and age, a social butterfly just means that she's on social media
a lot.
Yeah,
yeah. She's a social media whore, like, yeah. Not like that in that way, but she loved it. Like, she was always on cell phone.
She wouldn't put her phone down, I'm gonna say that.
You couldn't get her away from social media. She posts on Facebook, Instagram, and all that.
Right.
But she was very creative, and she had a reason to be on Facebook because,
she was promoting a business.
She was.
And they introduced a woman named Trina Williams. And Trina Williams introduced herself as her cousin. She described how her and Renita were thick as thieves. And then she also introduced Renita as Nunu. She said people would call her Nunu because she always got the new shit.
I run it up. They busy running their mouth. I'm a real ass, rich ass bitch from the south. Yeah.
They thick like these. They called each other Salt and Pepper because one was a fair skinned girl and one was a little brown skinned girl. Mm-hmm. And they said they used to do everything together. And they would love, love, love to get ready and go out and party and post to social media. That's what they think or whatever. So then Trina goes on to talk about the type of creativity that Nunu had and how she used her
skills.
She
talked about her entrepreneurial spirit. She really talked about how Nunu would decorate homes. She had a real eye for interior decorating. She would be given the money. The people would say, here, take my money, buy all the shit, come back and hook my house up, and that's exactly what she
did.
So people trusted her, they respected her in the neighborhood. She had the entrepreneur spirit. She had three kids she was taking care of. Like
she
her
did.
Mother said, she made sure her kids came for her. They made sure. They made it clear in that documentary. Mm-hmm. The mother made it clear, like, my daughter took care of her kids. She was about her business.
She was. And you'll see some pictures, like her kids always dressed to the nines. They would always be matching gear. Mm-hmm. And she had the hair to match. And she was
because
like, switch it up.
On the show, they actually brought in, I believe he was some type of politician. Was he the man?
I think he was a pastor.
Oh, no, yeah. He wasn't a politician. He was in the church.
He was her
same
pastor.
Difference. He came on the show and he was saying how, you know, the place where they grew up, where was it
called?
Shreveport.
Oh, yes. Shreveport, Louisiana.
That's where they were from?
From Cato Heights in Shreveport, Louisiana.
Yeah, Cato Heights.
Cato Heights.
I remember Cato Heights, but that's an area in Shreveport, Louisiana.
Yes.
But that's where they were from. So it was a hard knock life for them, but she made a way for her three kids. She was a single mother, and she had that entrepreneurial spirit. We can respect that because I love interior decorating.
Okay. We into it. Black girls got magic, okay? Yes. Y'all know that.
So she would just hook people houses up. I'm pretty sure it was amazing. They said even one of her showings, I should say, or showcases, went viral. So she was really popular. She had a lot of following. So like I said, she loved her social media following, and she gave them what they wanted.
Hey, girl, when you gonna learn? That's not your biggest shit.
All of her Yes. Pictures here, pictures there, videos here, live footage. So she loves social media. So.
Yeah, the show goes on to talk about how sometimes, I think her cousin Trina said that, and then her mom vouched that she would say things on her social media that wasn't necessarily, you know, people didn't like it.
It wasn't a nice thing.
She was very vulgar. She would use a lot of profanity.
Yeah, they say even sometimes they would shut her account down because some of the things she would say.
Right.
So she wasn't shy about telling them how she thought it was on her social media, right, how they described it.
Right. She would use a lot of vulgarity and do things like that. You know, people talk shit on Facebook.
Yeah.
And she would go to Facebook often to talk shit. Yeah. And Trina said that's how she was.
Yeah. And also, they introduced a brother in the show, Otis Williams, who talked about how she loved to gamble. She would love to go to the tables and talk her shit.
They said she was mean on the table.
She would live at the table.
She would live at the table and talk
shit. And she was good at it. So, she loved interior decorating. She loved gambling her money and hopefully making money from her gambling. I'm pretty sure she was making it. Because she was talking so much shit.
Right.
So, I like Nunu too. She seemed like my type of chick. I'm pretty sure. I wonder what her sign was.
Yeah, we should find out.
She coming off it. Like a...
Okay. Well,
yeah. But anyway. Now, the show starts to progress and start to talk about her relationship status.
Right. And she was dating a man named Jonathan Robinson. And you know about the two last name niggas.
Yeah, I don't know about them two last name niggas. I don't do that.
Jonathan Robinson was described as being cool, down-to-earth type of guy. He wasn't like a hothead. He wasn't known to be gangster.
Was cool.
He was a cool guy. That's all he really
was. They described him as also being really there for Renee Onunu. They really described him as, like, for instance, they gave an example one time, maybe she couldn't make it to a kid's school, and he was able to step in as a father figure and even go to the school for the kids. So they had a really good relationship. The only thing...
For 5 years,
their relationship.
They described it as having an on-again, off-again
relationship
for 5 years.
And
five
they said
years
that...
more on-again, off-again, I guess.
Well, they said she was cool with it because her business and her 3 kids, she was like, listen, I ain't got that time, so...
Yeah, so Jonathan Robinson, he was cool or whatever, but I'm thinking like, well, why he ain't settled down with Nunu? 5 years on again, off again, that's kind of weird. It's like, bruh, like, you like her or you don't, you need to let her go. And it seemed like Nunu, she had all her shit together. Like, why wouldn't he want to... not put a ring on it. I ain't say he had to marry the girl, but at least make it known that that's his lady, and that way she
can
be confident.
They had a couple photos of them going live.
Yeah, it seemed like they had. They have to do.
What's Summer Walker say?
What she say?
It was right at you doing the most, but we took a picture, can't post it. How that work? What you told? Can't back that shit up.
I ain't sharing no better.
That's what she said. That's what.
Well, anyway, the cousin and the mother described her as being basically like an open relationship. Everybody knew that Jonathan had another girlfriend in Houston. Renita.
Sharika.
Sharika and
he
Houston.
He had Nunu.
And he had Nunu, Renita,
and Shreveport.
And so... both, the mother said that both of them knew about each other.
Yeah,
the mother was like, oh, the girls knew about each other. I don't know. Well, they trying to act like they ain't know about each other. Because
it seemed like Sharika would talk shit about Renita online, and Renita would talk shit about Sharika online.
Yeah.
So
subliminals. Mad subs. We're doing some subs. I think in a video, they said she would say something like, you may have one that got the king, but I won the ace or
right,
something
you know,
like that.
Because
she was in the cars and all that.
Talking shit.
So, so they were those subliminals because it's like they knew about each other, but they wasn't sister wives.
Now, get this, y'all. He was with Sharika for 6 years. He had been dating on again, off again.
Nunu
for 5 years. So, I mean,
he really was like... up and down the highway, like
right.
Yeah,
it was a 4-hour drive.
And they would say that he would use that against the women. Like, if one of them was acting up, he'd spend more time with the other one.
Mm.
So if you acting up, he gonna just take himself away from you. Like, Jonathan, Jonathan Robinson.
Jonathan Robinson.
So, Jonathan, where were we? Drinking. Lost in a day. What the hell is thinking about this?
Might as well take a little bit of this jack.
Jack thing, yeah, Jack thing, y'all. The jack is out. The jack is unleashed. So, where were we? Otis described his sister as just like being that bitch. Like, everybody knew her. Everybody, all the guys wanted her. But she was dealing with Jonathan and his on-again, off-again relationship. And she didn't really care who had something to say about it. Her motto was, hated by many, confronted by none. Okay? That was literally like her pen pose, bitch.
Yes.
That was it for her. So, she was a tough chick. And so... what Jonathan used to do is, she had a lot of mouth, and so, like I said, he would use that to punish her, his time. He'll take his time away. And you know what? She was kind of like tired of that. After a while, because he had Sharika on the side, she was actually faithful to him the whole time, and she was tired of that.
Oh, Sharika?
No, not Sharika. Nunu was actually. Oh, mother said she was faithful to him. Mm-hmm. She got, like, she was pissed off at the point that it was like one-sided. You doing you, and I'm okay with it. Mm-hmm. But now you taking your time, you telling me she getting mad about this, and so now you know what I'm doing, because I've been faithful to you.
Right, he was shorting his trips.
Yeah. Well, so she started, she posted, look, she got posted up and said, bitch, I'm single, single for the
night. Now somebody tell them hoes I'm single for the night. Yeah, I'm single, nigga had to cancel that.
Hey, that's what she did. She said that she was single. She hit the club. She started posting every time she was out.
And she even met somebody. Who does she meet?
A guy named Naughty.
Naughty.
Yes.
Naughty.
She was feeling naughty.
Trina, her cousin, said, yeah, naughty.
And the crazy thing is, it's
very similar to Jonathan. They had that whole look. But keeping her options open. She was trying to be a choosy lover. So she chose Naughty for a little bit, and she put Jonathan on the back burner. Yeah. And of course, he didn't like that. But he was spending a lot more time with Sharika, his other girl, in Houston. All right, so they also describe another night where Jonathan drove his ass all the way from Houston to Shreveport to get her out of the club. He done pulled her out of the club like some scene on some movie, y'all.
Yeah,
some
pulled
movie.
Up. He pulled up.
He pulled up so she won't be on Facebook. Sharing her location and all that, telling people what she doing with Naughty Nordic. He went up in the club and pulled her ass out of the club, made a whole scene in front made a big old scene in front of everybody. So, of course, this pissed Nunu off, because she wasn't that type of chick that you could just tell her what to do. So she went on her Facebook and said, you know what, live on these bitches.
Yes.
I'm going off on Jonathan, and I'm going off on Sharika. So she's going off. They said she was up to almost 500 followers. So that's pretty much like the whole town. It's like, I don't know. But the whole goddamn KK No Heights was on her live. Like, who did what? So, of course, Jonathan, like, he was fed up. And Sharika was obviously embarrassed. She was hurt, feeling some type of way. So she and Jonathan here, like, da 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 da.
Oh, and then Sharika and Renita got into a war.
They started going back and forth. I think she went live and she went live, but they went live. They got a show. They're talking about my, you know, it's a whole bunch of my man and this my man, that and my man, and how that. I taste and all like, you know how it is.
You a dumbass, tired ass bitch. I got kids, I got family, I got A+ credit, I got a mother.
You know how we get black women, they get to be like, oh, girl,
especially on the internet, on the web.
Why? Because you just. Yes. Twitter fingering,
right. So they was going at it. We get to the night of this tragedy, the reason that we all here. We always got to get to this. Unfortunately, this is why tragedy. This is a true crime show, and it's really a tragedy.
Okay.
So, y'all, the night of the tragic event was April 12, 2018, and this was pretty early in the morning. Not that early in the morning, because... Nunu's mom talks about how Renita is Nunu, y'all. Yes, just so y'all know, we might go between names, Renita and Nunu. Renita and Nunu are the same person. Renita is her name. They use her name most often, her real name, in the documentary or show that we watched, Web of Lies. But Nunu was her nickname. And when you get to see the footage of the Facebook Live, she refers to herself as Nunu, just so y'all know. Trina describes how Renita had went and took her three kids to school. It was a school day, so the kids wasn't home. It was Nunu, her mom, and her brother. What's her brother's name? I don't know her brother's name. It was Nunu, her mom, and her brother.
Which was interesting because he didn't talk in this whole show. He didn't want to speak.
The brother was there. He was present at the tragic event. But he did not talk in the show.
Yes, he did not speak on the show. They didn't sit him down and speak with him at all. Which I'd like to know why, but I couldn't find that out.
Right. It probably was because it was only 2 years. They did this show kind of early.
Yeah, it's still fresh.
A lot of mother came in and tears. Wait. Just for respect for the family, like, give it some time. Because people would not be willing to talk about those things so fast. Especially the brother, because he was there on the night. It's Nunu, her mom, and her brother. And they all there chilling, probably on their phones. And somebody started banging on the door. I think they first heard, like, tire squeal. Then they heard banging on the door. And Jonathan made it known. Yeah, it's Jonathan. Nunu, open the door. Nunu, open the door. Nunu, and she waved him off like, go ahead, Jonathan, I'm not in the mood, I'm done with you. Mm-hmm. And he was like, we better open this damn door. And she did. She finally let him in. She let him in. Mm-hmm. And he said, you know, we need to talk. He's all outrageous. I don't know if he was drinking that day. I think he mentioned that he had been drinking that day or had some type of
When we get into his interrogation.
Right. So then he goes on, he storms back out because she obviously blowing him off. And she probably said some nasty things. She probably said some shit like, get the fuck out of my face, I'm done with you. And Jonathan goes to the car, comes back. I think he had a
45.
He came back with an AK-47.
Oh.
Big gun.
Okay,
big gun. He came back with AK-47. He started yelling at her, telling Nunu, you know, you going about to apologize to my girl for the shit you did on Yala.
Mm-hmm.
Mama in the kitchen, she comes out. She's like, what is you talking about? He fires at her mother. In her direction. He didn't hit her. He fired in her direction. She runs out the door, and she obviously is
scared. She bolts.
She leaves. Nunu is there with her brother still, and of course, at this point, they frantic. They wilding.
I think the mother ran out the back door.
Everybody's
going crazy, of course, and he shoots Nunu in the leg.
To prevent her from, you know, running as well. Mm-hmm. And the brother does not get shot, but he is still there. Let me tell you this, because you got to keep up with this part of the story. Mm-hmm. He tells Nunu's brother to let Nunu go live on his phone, because at that time, Nunu was blocked from Sharika's Facebook.
She had blocked on social media, so she couldn't see this apology that he wanted her to give. Anyway, so she said, go on your brother's phone. That way, my girl could see you apologizing. Because that's what he wanted. He wanted Nunu to apologize to Sharika, his other girlfriend in Houston.
And then he called Sharika on his phone. And he tells Sharika, go on your
life. Get ready for this apology.
You've been waiting for. That's the words he used. You about to get the apology you've been waiting for. Mm-hmm. And
I'm about to make this all better for you.
And then that's what happened. You see Nunu come on alive.
No, it was just, I apologize.
What's up?
That's why I got so, it blew up because her family and everything is watching it now.
Right.
Like, he's walking past, he's pacing back and forth behind her. She's on the floor, clearly. You can see. Right. She's on the floor on her camera. And people are like,
she's scared, y'all. She's very scared. You can tell in the video, look at her eyes, she's so scared.
She's so scared about what this boy's about to do or what he is capable of. Mm-hmm. She know.
And this is a former lover.
That's what I said. She laid down with him. She know what he capable of. But the cops show up, of course. The mother has to call the cops.
Right.
And remember, we started off with the mother's 911 call. Mm-hmm. They coming in blazing. All the mothers said, he's shooting.
Six units showed up.
And he started firing at them. He started to shoot at the police like he was Rambo. You know Rambo should have been a black man anyway, but whatever. Hey, that's off the topic. He turned into Rambo on the cops. So mm-hmm. he's shooting at the cops. He shot two cops, and one came close to actually dying.
Wow.
But both cops survived, but he ended up shooting two cops by the end of it. And he also turned around and he shot
Renita right there on Facebook Live.
Then he eventually gives up. He says, let's get into this interrogation.
Okay.
Because obviously the cops capture him. And we'll throw some clips so that we don't have to sit up here and try to describe and tell y'all what he said verbatim, because, you know, we've been smoking and drinking. So two of the things that really stuck out for us was the fact that he blamed his girlfriend.
It's like, you know, when you just say your wife, you know your wife not strong. And you know, people mess with your wife because they know she's not mentally stable. That shit, yo. That ain't no excuse for what I did, but I done hurt her so much. And I just got tired of people hurting her. She going to mental stages, and it's like, and everybody laughing at her. And I got tired of it. I told them, I don't want to laugh at you no more. I'm tired of hurting her. That ain't no excuse for what I did. Hate it, but man, I'm supposed to protect her.
The fact that he was blaming Sharika for going up there to kill Nunu, like, don't put that on her.
Right.
You've been cheating on this girl. As y'all heard, he put it on her like she was just so sensitive. He said that she would, if someone pricked their finger, she would cry. She would go into her own little world. So it's just like, you blaming her, you putting it on her.
What I didn't understand was why he used Sharika's name so much in the interrogation room, because clearly you was having sex with two women. At some point, you had to choose. At this point, 5 years into this bullshit, the women like, okay, enough of this. Clearly, Nunu, she was moving on. She had been posting about the guy, Morty. Mm-hmm. So it was like, okay, you did this because you was mad?
Yeah.
She was moving mad on? Or you just wanted her gone?
You just wanted it to be over. Because obviously, maybe he was feeling Sharika a little bit more, so he stopped fucking with Nunu and he wanted to ease up on that.
Mm-hmm.
So Sharika, seeing her going live, obviously, like he described, she goes into this whole thing, probably withholding sex, and that's probably a main thing that really got him enraged.
Sharika ain't want to fuck him no more.
She probably did. Probably was just like, I'm not really feeling you. Get it right or get out of my face. And so he had to make something.
He pissed because he can't go to Nunu now.
Let's talk about how you can't control your own feelings and your own body, your own hormones, Jonathan, because you probably couldn't stop yourself, because everybody said, like, you could have blocked her. There's no way for your girl to see the comments and the subliminal she making at her if she's blocked. Like you said, she blocked you. You should have blocked her. She out of our lives. But no, you didn't have enough willpower to say no to Nunu. You just wanted her to be done because you wasn't about to let nobody else fucking with Nunu.
Right. And then
couldn't stop on your own. You still reaching out to her 5 years over while you messing with Sharika. And Sharika had enough. And so you just like, listen, she got to be going, because I can't control myself not to keep in touch with her,
mm-hmm.
and I can't be having her out here with other men. So he was just like, she got to be going.
But instead,
then he goes into the interrogation room, talking about up the charges to the first murder one. Yeah, that's the second thing. He went in there and said, listen, I was in my right mind.
Do you wish to make a statement tell this happened? You do?
Yes.
Okay.
And I think I need to be charged with first degree.
Why?
Because I planned it. I knew what I was going to do.
All right.
I'm in my right mind. Mm-hmm. I ain't been smoking. I ain't been drinking. I knew what I drove 4.5 hours to do. So, yes. Nigga, you drove 4 hours and never thought about, like, hey, how is this going to affect Sharika after I go to jail for murder?
Don't do that for me. Don't ever care about it for me.
Don't ever.
Because that's a lot.
Y'all know y'all heard this. He made it sound like he was doing something honorable. Mm-hmm. Like he was protecting Sharika. That's not honorable.
No.
He took a whole nother life from 3 kids. Kids you cared for.
Yes, at some
chastity. Kids he cared for, and not only that, he had love for this woman too. I'm just gone down.
Y'all like, fuck it, it's over.
Game over, bitch.
Game over.
Now, bitch, game over.
It's over. No, this is not a game.
It's not a game.
This is real life. And now you just ended it like it was gonna go back to normal tomorrow.
Restart.
You just reset.
New life. No new life.
See, Jonathan. The problem with people.
He probably played too many video games.
He probably
new life.
Girl, she don't get no signs on man. And you talk about this game over. This is not a game. Then you shoot 2 cops and then went out there and told the police, hey, I thought y'all was gonna kill me. You've been watching too much TV, too much games, uh-huh. Too much TV. You thought you was gonna go out in a blaze of glory. And the cop said, why you thought we was gonna kill you?
Oh, because y'all just kill niggas anyway.
Right.
Why y'all ain't gonna kill me?
Yeah.
I've been shot by the cops before.
Yeah.
He got sentenced to life without the possibility of parole for Nunu's case, but then he also got an additional 100 years for the cop's shots.
Oh, yeah, because, you know, he did shoot 2 cops.
He did shoot 2 cops. So that was the sentence, and John thinking right now.
He don't deserve to come out of jail because he don't have no control of himself. What's that because you don't put it in
society? You couldn't control your dick, you couldn't control your fucking fingers.
And your emotions. Fingers. And you done drove 4.5 hours and had no rational thinking at all to say, this ain't right. This lady got 3 kids. I could really just cut her off and be done.
We four hours away from her, and we'd be good.
Yes, it's not like he had to do a
day in Houston.
What are you
she in Louisiana?
You talk about the whispers in the town. Come on,
grow up.
You'd rather admit to first degree murder than to say that you're the reason that Sharika was hurting, not Nunu.
You, nigga.
Yeah, it ain't got nothing to do with Nunu.
You
keep on talking about people hurting her. No, nigga, the first trigger should have been yours because you the one hurting her.
Yeah.
You the one hurting Sharika, not Nunu. That was just something you just wanted to pawn it off on. But I'm tired of talking to you, Jonathan. You don't even deserve my time. Goodbye.
Street porch where we do it big. Everything looking nice and we love G. 10 on 24, so I can take a pose.